happy Thursday. Happy Wednesday, everyone. We have a treat for you today. Oh my, all right, what we got for you guys? Coming back at you. Little warm up, inchworm knee to nose for 3 to 5 reps. Plank lean for 2 to down dog, 3 to 5 reps. Side lunge for 10, alternating. Sumo squat for 5, narrow squats for 3. 2 rounds of that just to get the body warmed up, legs just kind of generally ready to go. And then we're gonna move into a little run of 100 meters or cardio of choice. And I'll walk you through some of those options on the workout description. Back lunge for 10, alternating. Into our single arm, sumo deadlift high pull for 5 aside, and our lateral dumbbell jump over for 10 alternating reps. Just again, get the ankles ready, get everything fired up. As you get closer to the workout, I want you to substitute some of the work or movements in the workout in your warm-up. Just if you're skipping for today, grab your skipping rope, skip in there instead of the lateral jump overs, or if you're doing any other option in there, please substitute that in to make sure that you're getting those movements ready to go and warmed up. 2 to 3 rounds of that, and then we're gonna move into the work set for tomorrow. In terms of that, we have a 30-minute cutoff for this work set, so in 30 minutes, you're gonna take down 10 rounds, or one of the options I give you. You'll do single arm sumo deadlift high pull for 15 aside. All right, moving into our 200-meter run, or cardio of choice, and then double unders for 50. And then you'll rock that for 10 rounds, or 30 minutes comes by, call it a day, have some fun, and enjoy. Good little work set, gassing work set. Let's have some fun today, let's warm you up. All right, guys, let's get those feet under the hips. We'll take the arms big and tall, big stretch. We'll reach it over to one side. We'll come back through, reach it to the other side. And from here, we'll come back to center. We're gonna scratch our back and reach through the elbow. We'll come back up, big stretch. Stretch out those arms from those front squats yesterday. Good, big stretch up. We're gonna forward fold all the way down. Touch those toes, lock the shins, nice flat back. We'll come down, frame a foot, step it back into your lizard. And from here, we're gonna lower the knee, press the hip. We'll come back to center, straighten out that leg a bit. We'll plant that foot, press the hip, back to center, straighten out the leg. One more time, press the hip, back to center, straighten out the leg. Back through, straighten out the back leg, step and switch. So we're in our nice lizard again on the other side. We'll lower the knee in the back, press the hip, back through center, straighten out that leg in the front. Come back through, press the hip, back to center, straighten out that leg in the front. Do one more time, plant that foot, press the hip, and back to center, and straighten that leg. Plant the foot, straighten out the back leg, step into your down dog. Setting those shoulders, we're gonna walk the heels a few times just to make sure things feel pretty darn good today. And then from there, come back into our plank, tiptoe those feet all the way up. We're gonna roll ourselves up, big, tall stretch up overhead, a little shrug. We'll come back down with the hands. But if you'd like to do any extra little gentle cores or warm up, please do so. Pause the video, take that down, we'll get you guys ready. I'm gonna move into that first work set, which is gonna kickstart off with an inchworm knee to nose. So I'm gonna turn it face this way so you guys can see profile. I can take the arms up big and tall if you'd like, or not, it's up to you on that one. I'm gonna hinge, I'm gonna lock myself out into my plank. Once I set up in that good plank, pulling the ribs and hips together, pressing the shoulders together, I'm gonna squeeze the knee to nose, come back into the plank, knee to nose, back into the plank, and then walk my hands back in. Rolling myself up, big tall stretch if I like or not, depending on if you want to get your shoulders a little extra level. But nice and smooth, finding that good hollow position, that good core, that good solid shoulder before you take that knee up into the nose. And remember, take it slow. Work that for compression. Work it for that strength side of things. After that, we move into our plank lean to down dog. So from here, I'm going to show you one rep from the side, one from the front. I get set up in my plank. Again, establishing that good hollow. So I pull my ribs and hips, press my shoulders together. I'm going to lean to the left, focusing on that upper body engagement. Lean to the right. Come back to center. I'm going to pull my hips back and up into that down dog. And then come back into center. And then you're gonna get set up for that next rep. So my next
back strap, I'll just show you from the front so you can see that lean. I get set up with my hands. I'm gonna get tight through my body, pull the ribs and hips together, press straight through. I'm gonna lean, keeping myself square to the floor. Lean, square to the floor. Come back, make sure my shoulders are solid for my down dog as I pull the hips back. Find that good down dog, feel those lats kick on, and then come back through and take it for the rest. So play around with that, you guys. Make sure, again, those shoulders are being nice and activated throughout the entire lean, and focus on those lats and that nice stabilization through those arms and shoulders as we pull back up into that down dog. Don't rush those. Move really well. Move with intent, and really think, perhaps, if you'd like to, add in some extra little heel presses if you'd like to wake up the ankles, or even some shoulder touches on those down dogs. It's up to you. Our next exercise, we come back up to our feet, and we're gonna get set up with a nice wide stance position. My toes are gonna be turned slightly out. I'm nice and tall, solid and engaged. I'm gonna think squat. I'm gonna pull my hip to my heel, and I'm gonna keep my body as upright as I can. So I'm working on opening up that ankle, working on opening up that hip a bit, and then I push through, come tall. Again, other side, I take it all the way down, keeping that knee kind of in line with my toe, and my body as upright as I can. I wanna think squat even though I'm doing a side lunge. So hip to heel, very important, loading that midfoot and not the toes. After those side lunges, we move into some squats. So we're gonna move into our sumo squat. So my feet will come in from my side lunge position. I get myself set up in this wider stance, and I go to the side so you guys can see. So my feet are both the same width from what they just were. I'm going to press my knees out super active as I take those hips down and keep my body nice and upright as I work through those good squat mechanics. So again, hip to heel, but only going as deep as we can maintain position. So we really have to pay attention to our back position on those sumo, because we can tend to get a little deeper on the sumo, and we don't want to go too deep and lose position. So again, hips go back and down, knees go out, solid flat foot contact, nice pressure through the feet. Our next round of squats, we come into our narrow stance. So if my normal squat stance is here, my narrow stance can be anything inside of that. It doesn't have to be touching it together. But if you'd like to, you can go there. We want to think about our normal squat mechanics. So I get set up, tall, I pull the hips to the heels, my knees track the toes, I stay as upright as I can, I focus on that balance, that midfoot balance, and then I press through those feet to stand up nice and tall. So again, with that position, we really want to make sure we're working on our balance and trying to keep our weight through the midfoot the entire time. It's really easy to fall backwards or even come forward on the toes on those narrow squats. So take your time, work that range that you can stay balanced with. As a quick recap, what we have for you guys, we have our inchworm knee to nose for 3 to 5. We have our plank lean for 2 into down dog for 3 to 5 reps. Side lunge for 10 into our sumo squat for 5. If you'd like to add a tempo in there, you can. And then we move into our narrow squat to warm up those ankles and those shins for 3 reps. 2 rounds, take it down, pause the video, come back to me. We're gonna move into our next phase, which is gonna continue to warm up the legs and a key movement with the dumbbell. So what we got coming up next for you guys involves starting off with a little bit of a run or cardio piece of choice. So take that down, hit it up hard, see where it takes you. After that, what we have is our back lunge. So I'm gonna turn profile so you guys can see. I'm gonna stay as upright as I can as I keep my shoulder, hip, and knee aligned as I step back. So I'm gonna step my foot back, I'm gonna lower down, touch my knee to the floor if I can, or just hover and come as close as I possibly can, and then stand back up. So I'm trying to work on that good balance, that timing that allows me to focus on good position and work on that nice back lunge. A nice thing to think about is squeezing your glutes before you make that step. It'll help stabilize the knee and keep things solid. If you're not comfortable with the back lunge dynamically, you can start off in that squat stance, step into that nice lunge position, and we can work on that standing lunge drill and work through that range of motion with a little bit more control and not have to worry about finding our stance. We've already got our stance. So that's an option as well. 5 per side if we're gonna do the standing lunge drill. After that, we move into our single arm sumo deadlift high pull.
I'm gonna get the dumbbell, and I'm gonna face you guys for the first couple reps. I'm gonna stand right over top of this dumbbell, so it's cutting my foot in half. I pull the hips back, and I lower down. My chest is a little bit more upright, so I'm kind of sitting in this like I was gonna do a snatch. I'm gonna stand through the legs, open through the hips, and let that momentum carry the dumbbell up to my sternum, and then come back down. I'm not trying to hold it here, I just touch that end range, come back down with control. So I take it down to the floor or wherever I feel control, stand up, and just carry it through with the arm and find that position. From here as well, I get that position from the side so you can see my hinge. I get nice and set, weight through that midfoot, stand up, and work that nice drive through the legs and the hips. And again, using the momentum through the legs to carry that dumbbell up so it doesn't turn into a stand up and a pull with the arm. So focus on that, focus on those legs and that good, strong back position in that sumo deadlift high pull. Our last exercise on the list is a lateral dumbbell jump over, or you can substitute that for skipping if you'd like. But my dumbbell is in the middle, I get set, and I'm just gonna jump, or I'm gonna skip, or I'm gonna step. I can also do a high knee step if I'd like, or I can keep it low and work it nice and quick. So we're just gonna use that to get our body moving around a little bit, get those ankles ready, and that heart rate up a little bit more as well. But remember, if you're skipping in the workout, do that maybe for a round and then substitute the skipping in just so you can get the rhythm with the rope. Quick little recap, we have 2 to 3 rounds of that, a little run, 100 meters, or cardio of choice, depending on what you got going on there or what you're choosing, into 10 back lunges or a standing lunge drill, into our sumo deadlift high pull for 5 per side, and then we're gonna move into our lateral dumbbell jump over to get those bodies ready to heat it up. Pause the video, take that down, get that ready to go, and then come join me. We're gonna talk about what's coming up in that work set. In our workout, we have 30 minutes, right, to get 10 rounds or your desired rounds of choice that I'll have in the workout description as well, there for you. You are going to take down 15 sumo deadlifts per side. Remember to use those legs, focus on your positions, and really make sure those legs and hips are doing the work, not the arm, right? The bicep starts gassing out too soon, think about those legs. You're then gonna head out the door, get a little run in, or pop on your treadmill, wall run, lots of options there I'll give you guys, and have some fun with those. Take that down about 200 meters, or that equivalent to what I give you in that workout description. And then you're gonna finish off with a little bit of skipping, right? Or workout equivalent to that skip, which will be down in the workout description. So there's gonna be a lot of options for this one, you guys. Pick your adventure, have some fun with this one. It's a great workout. And take advantage of that beautiful weather while we have it and get you guys outside if you can. Till tomorrow, have a fantastic day. Crush this one.